Let's talk about the AstraZeneca issue that we're talking. We have reports of blood clots, coagulation, and this may raise some concerns with certain groups of people. How would you respond to this? Like, you know, how do we make sense of these reports?
Yes, it that's very difficult, in fact, to make sense out of it. There's two sides to the story. The first one is the general one, which is, for instance, all why the European Medicine Agency has said, authority has said, that there is no real problem. And that is, again, you look at the number of people that would get coagulation problems in that period normally, and you compare it to the number of side effects that you see after vaccination. And then again, the number is lower than normally seen. So from that perspective, people say that the risk is so low that that you might simply go ahead with vaccination. That's what most specialists in Europe also think. They think that governments are being too careful, that basically one should go ahead with vaccination because vaccination is saving many more lives than might be at risk. So that's one approach. The other one is that some specialists say that this is an unusual type of coagulation that you do not frequently see, and that, you know, in a very small number of people, there might be a risk. Now, the people we are talking to about tonight are not in that risk group. So the risk group are basically women somewhere between 20 and 50, 55. That's been the group in which there has been a very limited number. So in Great Britain, there's been millions and millions of people that have been vaccinated. And I think they had about 7 cases where this was happening. So, you know, it's one in a million or one in millions where this is happening. So it's a, you know, I read about one specialist that said that the risk actually is lower than the risk of being struck by lightning. And so, you know, keep that in mind. And also keep in mind that when you get a disease, that your risk of getting serious disease, specifically when you are an older person, is a lot higher than that risk of such a side effect. So overall, I think that doctors come to the conclusion that it would be wise to continue vaccinating and not stop now.